Dear listener, welcome to my channel. Topic of this video is periodic and non-periodic signal. Focus of this video is mainly on exercises of periodic and non-periodic signal. First, we will see the definition of periodic signal. When a discrete time signal x of n satisfies the condition x of n plus capital N is equal to x of n for any positive integer value of n, then given signal x of n is periodic. Otherwise, the given signal is aperiodic or non-periodic in nature. That is, to become a signal as a periodic, the condition is x of n is equal to x of n plus capital N, where n capital N is fundamental period. The signal may be represented as x of n is equal to x of k into capital N plus N is also periodic signal where k is an integer. To show that the signal is periodic or aperiodic, we generally take n in the form of 2 pi capital M, where M is an integer. Now first we will see the example when the signal becomes periodic and when the signal becomes non-periodic. Now see the first example, y cos n by 6 is a periodic signal. Now our basic equation of periodic is x of n should be equal to x of n plus capital N. And the condition of n, it should be positive integer. Basic our equation, that is input example, is x of n is equal to cos n by 6. Now we replace n with the n plus capital N, because this is the equation, x of n should be equal to x of n plus capital N. X of n is equal to cos of n plus n by 6. After that, solving the equation, we get cos of n by 6 plus capital N by 6. We can apply the simple trigonometric formula. Cos A plus B is cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Now, in this equation, if we want this equation equate to our cos N by 6, the condition is that cos N by 6 answer should be 1 and sin N by 6 answer should be 0. Because when this answer is 0 and when this answer is 1, the condition gets satisfied, that is x of N is equal to x of N plus capital N. The condition is that this value should be 0 and this value should be 1. Now n by 6 is equal to 2 pi, which we'll check the randomly value, and we found that for n by 6 is equal to 2 pi, we are getting the answer, this answer as 0 and this answer as 1. So n by 6 is equal to 2 pi, so n becomes 12 pi. Now here we observe that n is not an integer. Now cos 12 pi by 6 equal to 1 and sin 12 pi by 6 equal to 0. That is, we just put the value of n, that is 12 pi, and here the cos of 2 pi is 1 and sin of 2 pi is 0. So we are getting the equation x of n is equal to cos n by 6. So this equation gets satisfied, but what is the condition? That n must be positive integer. But when we assign, when we take that random values, at that time the n gets 12 pi, which is not a positive integer. Therefore this signal is aperiodic or non-periodic in nature. Now see the next example, y cos pi n by 6 is a periodic signal. Equation is x of n is equal to x of n plus capital N. X of n is equal to cos of pi n plus 6. X of n, we want to replace n by n plus capital N. Therefore pi n plus capital N and this divided by 6. Equation becomes cos of pi n by 6 plus pi n by 6. This is small n and this is capital N. We expand the equation by that formula of cos A plus B is equal to cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Now to equate to your original equation, this value should be equal to 1 and this value should be equal to 0. That is, cos pi capital N by 6 should be equal to 1 and sin pi capital N divided by 6 equal to 0. So this is possible when that values are equal to 2 pi. So pi N by 6 is equal to 2 pi. We are getting the value of n is equal to 12. Now observe that n is a positive integer. That is, if we put the value, that is sin pi n, n we are getting as a 12. So when we put the value n equal to 12, we are getting the answer here 0 and here we are getting the answer 1. And again we are getting the original equation x of n is equal to cos pi n by 6. But in this x of n is equal to x of n plus n and it is periodic, because whatever the n assign is a integer, positive integer, that's why it is a periodic signal, and while the previous signal is aperiodic, because whatever the n assignment comes as a 12 pi, which is not a positive integer. So this is the difference between the periodic and aperiodic signal. Now we will see the some exercises on the periodic and aperiodic signal. For example, x of n is equal to cos of 0.01 pi n. To show that whether the signal is periodic or aperiodic, we require to replace n by n plus capital N. Therefore, cos of 0.01 pi n plus n. Now we require to check this term, that what should be replaced for n. So 0.01 pi capital N should be equal to 2 pi m, because generally we equate this value with respect to 2 pi, and m is a always any multiple or integer value. 0.01 n is equal to 2 m, and by solving the equation we are getting the value as n equal to 200 m. And now we can see that n is a positive integer, m value can be 1, 2, 3. If the values of m are in the range from 1, 2, 3, n is always positive integer. Therefore, n equal to 200 represents the fundamental period and signal is periodic in nature. Now here we replace x of n is equal to cos of 0.01 pi n plus 200, because we are getting n is equal to 200 m, we put m equal to 1, so we replaced capital N by 200. Equation becomes x of n is equal to 0.01 pi n plus 2 pi, and we can find out that the signal becomes periodic, because when 2 pi gets added, the signal repeats after that particular interval. Therefore, x of n is equal to x of n plus capital N. So signal is what? Periodic in nature. And this is just representation, that this original signal is represented having the fundamental period of 200. Next equation, x of n is equal to cos 3 pi n. The first step is replace n by n plus capital N. After that, we require to take the terms 3 pi n, and which is we require to equate with the 2 pi m. 3 pi n is equal to 2 pi m. By solving the equation, we are getting the answer n is equal to 2 m by 3. From here, we can find out that if the values of m is multiple of 3, we are getting the n as a positive integer. So here, we can put values of m in the range of multiple of 3, and the fundamental period of the signal is 2, that is n equal to 2, and signal is periodic in nature. For first two problems, we just check whether it is correct or not. X of n is equal to cos 3 pi n plus 2. X of n is equal to, here m is equal to 3. X of n is equal to cos 3 pi n plus 6 pi. And if we plot in any software or in any programming language, we can see that x of n is equal to x of n plus capital N. So this signal is a periodic signal with a fundamental period of 2. Next is x of n is equal to cos of 3n. The same procedure, n is replaced by n plus n. 3n is equal to, we show that in the form of 2 pi m. N is equal to 2 pi m divided by 3. Now you can easily check that for any value of integer m, n cannot be integer, because which term is coming? Pi, and which is a irrational term or not rational term. So n can never be integer. So signal is aperiodic or non-periodic in nature. Now again we check x of n is equal to cos 3n plus 2 pi. X of n is equal to cos 3n plus 2 pi. Still this equation equates, but the signal is not periodic, because whatever the value of n we are getting is not a positive integer. Now next is x of n is equal to cos n by 8 plus cos of pi n by 8. Now signal is composed of two parts. So first part we replace with the n1, and second part we replace with the n2. X of n is equal to cos n plus n1 by 8 plus cos pi n plus n2 by 8. Here we replace n by n plus n1, and here we replace n by n plus n2. Now n1 by 8 is equal to 2 pi m1, and n pi n2 by 8 is equal to 2 pi m2. By solving the equation we are getting n1. So here n1 can't be integer for any value of m1. Therefore signal is aperiodic in nature. But for the second part, we can say that n2 is equal to 16 m2, where m2 can be 1, 2, 3, 4. And when m2 is in this range, the signal is periodic in nature with the fundamental period 16. But as it is a combination of aperiodic and periodic signal, the final signal is non-periodic in nature. This is the just graphical illustration in a MATLAB that the signal is aperiodic. This is the final signal and which shows the aperiodic in nature. Now see the next. X of n is equal to cos of 2 pi n by 5 plus cos of 2 pi n by 7. Now again signal is composed of two portions. Here we again replace this first portion by n plus n1 and second portion by n plus n2. Now we equate 2 pi n1 phi divided by phi is equal to 2 pi m1. 2 pi n2 divided by 7 is equal to 2 pi m2. Here n1 is, after solving we are getting n1 is equal to 5 m1 and here n2 is 7 m2. Now we can say that for m1 and for even for this equation, that is for m1 and m2, they may be from 1 to 3, and when the range are in this range, values of m1 and m2, at that time n1 and n2 represent the positive integer. Therefore the signal, that both parts are periodic in nature. So this signal is periodic having the fundamental period 5. This signal is periodic having the fundamental period 7. So in this case we require to calculate the fundamental period of entire signal as LCM of 5 and 7. LCM of 5 and 7 is 35. So 35 is the fundamental period of X of n. This is just graphical representation. Next is X of n is equal to sine pi plus 0.2n. Now here don't confused that pi is present, but this is nothing but the phase. We require to check with the n terms. Now sine pi plus 0.5, n is replaced by n plus capital N. Now we equate 0.2n is equal to 2 pi m. We are getting n is equal to 10 pi m. So we can easily conclude that for any value of n, m, n cannot be integer. Therefore signal is aperiodic in nature. Next is X of n is equal to e raised to j pi by 4 into n. Now we know the equation e raised to j theta is equal to cos theta plus j sin theta. First we expand the signal, that is X of n is equal to cos pi n by 4 plus j sin pi n by 4. This is the first part and this is the second part. N is replaced by n plus n1. This n is replaced by n plus n2. Now we try with the n1 value, that is pi n1 by 4 is equal to 2 pi m1. Pi n2 by 4 is equal to 2 pi m2. After the solving the equation, we are getting n1 is equal to 8 m1, n2 is equal to 8 m2. So for m1 and m2, when the values are in the range from 1 to 3 dash dash dash, this n1 and n2 both are periodic in nature and their fundamental period is 8. Therefore signal is periodic in nature. X of n is equal to e raised to j pi n by 8 minus 1. Now expand this equation, e raised to j pi n by 8 into e raised to minus j. Now we are getting the two terms. Now here just see the terms e raised to minus j. E raised to minus j is not a function of time, that is n factor is not associated and it represents a complex factor. So when to calculate periodic or aperiodic, we require to consider only this portion, that is e raised to j pi n divided by 8. Now the problem is same as previous problem. Two parts are there. N is replaced by n plus n1. N is replaced by n plus n2. We calculate the n1. Here n1 we are getting 16 pi m1. N2 is 16 pi m2. So both signals are periodic having the fundamental period 16. And therefore the final signal is periodic in nature. Now even there is no need to solve the problem, even by observing the problem carefully you can easily check whether the signal is periodic or aperiodic. X of n is equal to sine root 2 pi n. X of n is equal to sine root 2 pi n is replaced by n plus n. Square root of 2 pi n is equal to 2 pi m. N is equal to square root 2 m. For here square root is again not a rational number, so for any value of integer m, n cannot be integer. Therefore signal is aperiodic and or non-periodic. Next, even don't confuse, this pi is nothing but the phase. There sine 2 sine 7n by 3, so we require to consider this. Here we are getting n is equal to, by solving this we are getting n is equal to 6 pi m by 7. You can easily conclude that n can be never be integer because pi factor is assigned here and which is a not a rational number. So the signal is what? Aperiodic in nature. Similarly, the similar example, only you just remember that this is a phase value and we require to exclude. We require to consider only the terms related with time. That is nothing but the n value here. So phi u pi n is replaced by n plus capital N. After the solving the equation, we are getting the value. And here the fundamental period is 16 and m should be in the multiple of phi. Signal is periodic in nature. Similarly, the same problem, cos of phi, similar level type of problem, cos of phi pi n divided by 9 plus 1. We check with this value here. Again, the signal is periodic in nature with a fundamental period of 18 and m should be in the range of multiple of 5. So these are the some exercises. Practice is required. So you try with these exercises. If any problem, put the question in comment box. Even I have given the answer and hint also there. So try to solve the problem. So these are the few exercises on periodic and aperiodic. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my videos, subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.